A very warm welcome to you. It's a pleasure, as always, to have you join us on this edition of Almond Finance and Wealth Reports, your source for latest happenings in the financial services sector of the economy. I am Jennifer Obidiebube. On this edition of the program, we join Faith and her guests on a town hall for the continuation of the explosive session on capital adequacy in the insurance industry. Real or not? Do take a listen.
You cannot talk beyond your level of understanding. And I sympathize with his disappointment. One, why do I need government to legislate for people to buy insurance? Do they legislate for me to take taxi?
On this edition also, we will bring you highlights of the fourth valedictory lecture of the Chartered Institute of Bankers of Nigeria, CIBN, in honor of Mr. Phillips Odoza, the former Group Managing Director of UBA, at the Harbour Point Event Centre, Victoria Island. And then we'll take you through our brand new segment where we celebrate people, dead or alive, who have contributed their quota to the growth and development of their industry, rightly tagged industry icons. These and more are what we have on the lineup this week, so sit back, relax and enjoy it. Details coming right up after this message from our sponsors. Please stay with us.
Your anchor has insurance, fire protection, insurance, safety on wheels, insurance, all-round guarantor.
Insurance protects your business. Take advantage of cargo, hull, liability, freight and other marine insurance policies for the maritime sector. Are you an owner of private or commercial vehicles? It is compulsory that you take the minimum insurance to protect other road users and their properties. Fire insurance policy is compulsory for all owners of schools, hospitals, hotels, malls and other public buildings. The Insurance Act of 2003 mandates you to take fire insurance policies. Be on the right side of the law. Protect your businesses and assets. Visit any insurance broker or company today to get the right policy for you and your business. This message is from the Nigerian Insurance Association, NIA.
From your perspective from the academia, what do you see that is kind of the problem with the insurance industry in Nigeria?
We've been telling it to the government over the years that the problem of insurance is not raising the share capital, but allow people to go at their level. That's insurance company to go at their level, like the model. If we just like microfinance, you have big banks, you have small banks, medium banks, you have microfinance that goes to the grassroots. Now I don't understand why micro insurance has not taken root in Nigeria now. And you cannot believe that the bulk of this money lies in the hands of Iyalata, the pepper seller, all these small people. Bring them together, have a way of securing them, and then get little premium. And by the time you put them together, you are talking about a very large bulk of premium. So instead of running after oil and gas is good, but you discover that it's more premium, if you put them together, 500 naira or 1,000 naira per month to insure somebody's life or an endowment at the end of 2 years or even at the end of the year, Christmas savings and whatever, you are talking about very large amount of premium. You know, but how many of our insurance companies have been that? Instead of coming down to the grassroots, they are running after
NNPC and all that. Okay, Mr. Reverend Ajayi, I know you're a very vast and an experienced practitioner. I do know that, and you would agree that in the UK, for example, you have specialist companies. Like, you can tell, okay, these guys, if you take a business to them, they are very good with motor. this one is fire. Why is it that we don't have such specialist companies in Nigeria? Everybody seems to be doing the same account.
The issue here is we are talking about capitalization of insurance.
Insurance, yes.
So I won't waste my time going to the emotional outburst of my friend on the left. what I know is that there are problems and challenges facing Nigerian insurance industry in the distribution of its trades, of the business. Insurance culture is part of maintenance culture. And if maintenance culture does not exist in Nigeria, insurance culture cannot exist. And all this talk of captive market, all these market women, women on the street, have you ever tried to sell insurance to these so-called low-level income earners? And have you ever noticed the attitude towards insurance? When we are talking about micro insurance, Lasako established a policy for Okada riders. It was going to be 600 naira per annum, 600 naira per annum. And we needed to, you know, railroad them to buy it. And when you go to Ibobi, you see a lot of people that are there because of
Okada accident.
But they don't understand. They see it as an additional taxation. Now, in a place like UK, anything the government cannot do for you is insurance that we do it.
Exactly.
But in Nigeria, as I am now, if you tell me that, somebody has stolen, I've lost my car, and I ask you, have you insured it? And you say you don't insure, you expect me to give you minimum of 50,000 naira. Oh, Mr. Aladipo Ajayi, you should have given me. We have our own insurance systems that are not already. If you have a car in the UK and you don't get it insured, if you lose it, that's all. Your friend will just say, oh, too bad. There is absence of credit. When you have credit system working, your creditor will insure for you even if you don't want to insure. And then you get it to do the knowledge of insurance. So in Britain, the market is up there. You can have a niche for yourself. My former MD told me when he was training in UK, his own area was householders policy alone. And that was what they did in their branch. And every day they had more than 120 letters from their policy holders. Because there is abundance of the market, then you can create a special area for yourself and be a specialist in it, and everybody will know that that company, that's what they do. So if you are only going to do householders policy, you don't need all the capital that I need for engineering, for life, so you can carve a niche. So this is exactly what I'm saying, that this risk-based capital is going to take the pressure off the industry of raising capital every day. If Faith Insurance Company has adequacy of capital, Lajipo Ajayi Insurance Company is not benefiting from that. If I don't have, I will be the only one. Nicon will say, go and do something about your capital. You don't have to increase. If you don't have money, scale down. Buy more insurance or merge. You choose what you want to do. It doesn't affect everybody in the industry. Now your shareholders will be able to assess you from what you are doing and say, oh boy, we cannot put more money because you haven't paid dividend and all that. so you now say, scale down. You have options. But these ones, I mean, this regime that we are doing, there are no options. When they come, whether your adequacy or not, I mean, whether they have tested the adequacy of one insurance company or not, everybody in one fell swoop just change. That's the challenges that we were facing, which my friend was alluding to. But now, as I've said, you can scale your operation according to the money you have. Everybody just berates insurance companies. I'm glad to be out of it because it's like a madhouse. When you go, all these shareholders, when they come, they shout, pru, 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 pru. How many of them have bought insurances in those companies they say they have policies? If you ask my friend, he doesn't have a third-party insurance as he's sitting down there and he's berating insurance companies. If you ask him now, he has more than 5 accounts in different banks. And he can just, if you ask him now, if he's going to be honest, he will bring ATM cards of various banks. People, when they get sacked from work, the first place when they get their money, the first point is to go and put whatever little money they get from their employers into bank. And then they will come and give up their policies. There is a factory directly opposite my company in Nikeja. When one laborer was sacked, he started a life policy 2 years. He paid premium only 1 day, 1 month. He didn't continue. 24 months later, he was sacked. He came to Lasako, he wanted to get his money.
He hasn't acquired something.
So I am not saying the insurance industry has done enough, but we have challenges. And the National Insurance Company is trying to streamline. And this streamlining has been a lot of challenges for us. No premium, no cover has always been a challenge. And when the government came with it, it drastically reduced the inflow of premium. But I am ready to live with that, because over time, we will get over it. You need to make some sacrifices for the long-term benefit. It was no point recording without making something. Most of the insurance companies, they had large receivables. And when we were gravitating to international financial reporting standards, we had to write off. We had to write off. And my friend is talking about...
You say that's part of the reason why dividend payout insurance.
When you have a company that deals with government, you have 8 local governments before, and each one of them was owing you premium. Now they divide them into 14 local governments. None of them is going to pay, because they say it's no longer our business. We didn't share the liability, and you had to write off. So it has advantages and challenge and advantages. Lagos State government, I can say it anywhere, is the most risk conscious government in Nigeria. Because even before the elements of, the time of compulsory group life insurance, right from the time of Asiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu, he has insured everybody in his wards, from gate man to governor. He insured them. But there are other things that the Lasako cannot assess in Lagos State government. There is no monopoly again for Lasako. Lagos State is free for everybody. People participate, support them, and so it's a challenge. It's not a kind of closed job. But what I can say, give it to NICOM. They have sort of streamlined the industry, and we are still a leader in this environment. We are still a leader. If he has facts and figures to compare. But what we have come here to discuss is what the solution to these frequent capital requirements are. And I am saying this risk-based capital is it, because it will allow everybody to go at their pace. You don't have to compel people. If you want to be a big player and you don't have the money, I also want to be a big player, I don't have the money, we can come together. Even internationally, M&A is something that is encouraged. So that when you have the merger and acquisition, you become stronger, not necessarily asking for shareholders' money, you become stronger and you get a good share of the market. Now, when you have a good share of the market, definitely you are going to reduce the number of players. And there will be people will be a lot more sensible in the way they do it. You are an insurance journalist, and you know all the problems of the industry. Rates are at rock bottom. We are doing good business, but the rating structure is so much
depleted. Who is responsible for the rating?
Would
you say is responsible for the rating business?
The rating is an element of competition. If you look at
demand and supply,
yes, it's the forces of market. If you look at in terms of the assets we are insuring, compared to the assets they are insuring, even in South Africa, we have more assets to insure. But where South Africa we charge 100 naira percent for a particular risk, we will be charging 25 kobo.
Why do you people charge that?
It's competition. It's competition. It's competition because somebody will go to him. There is no rate in Nigeria that you cannot bring down. This is in Nigeria, is only in the industry. Even when the federal government wanted to start the group life scheme, the budget for the group life scheme was something in the neighborhood of 20 something billion naira, which the government has calculated based on advice from actuaries. Now, when they said go to the market and bring rates, one low-cost insurance company that nobody knows brought the rates down to about 6 billion. And everybody was forced to go on that rate because that was the best rate. So there are challenges.
Okay, Mr. Ajayi, I'm still going to come to you. But maybe Mr. Okay, so I'm still going to come to you because.
Okay, with due respect, Mr. Ajayi, no, this excuse you are giving to us is not acceptable. Yeah,
we're here. You are not here to accept my excuse.
Please.
You are not here to accept my excuse because it's not a union.
You have been speaking for long.
It's not a union matter.
Please allow me.
You are just here to discuss an issue that relates to capital.
Please allow me.
If you want to talk like a unionist, then we will talk like unionists.
Please allow me.
You don't attack.
Don't attack my person. No.
Talk about the issue at hand.
Yes, that's what we're doing. You see, the problem we have today, like I said earlier, potential. You have given us excuse of, you know, example of Okada riders. They have gone to able to get money there. This is why you use the state, you know, apparatus as the one of the shareholder of the company. Say, look. These Okadas are causing more harm to the state. A mega city who operated. We want to take this insurance, you know, I mean this motorcycle rider to insure them. If it is 600 or 500, you know, go to every local government. The Lagos state will write all the local government. This policy, we have seen it, and it's going to help our people to reduce the risk of all this, you know, accident will happen in Lagos state. With go to Alumosho or whatever, Barega, Shomolu, Koshobo, a whole lot of Okada operated, even when the state restricted them from applying the highway, this express, you know, they're still, you know, defaulting those order and applying. If you had not seen that business very well, they make a lot of money. My brother was telling, you know, paper sellers, all this, they have not financed it, you know. There's no gun ask. I can't patronize you. I have most insurance policy, I take my cars. I do that. But if I'm doing another business risk, you know, that I need to insurance, I will go. That's the truth. By the time year ends, I've done it. I renew my car, something like that. If you're dealing with every Okada rider, the insurance will swim with the money. That's the truth. That was said, the policy there. And introduce this good idea to Lagos State Government, which I know very well, they will back it up on. Because some of them, like for example today, government has said that every high-rising building should be insured. It is the insurance sector. They mostly will go to the neck of the government. Be on their neck to enforce this. I know they don't have the police to enforce it. That's the truth. But how many of them have made that move? The Michael will pronounce the star in Abuja. He's not alluding the regulators. They cannot even, you know, go against the regulators. That's the truth. But I can speak against them. They don't regulate me. They are regulating them. That's the problem. Every policy the man chunk out there from Abuja, it's not even helping them. It's hurting them. And that's the truth.
And they can use no premium, no cover.
Why other insurance companies are paying dividend today? He said, I shouldn't compete. I can compete next. They are putting the same market. They are putting the same sector. Why are they paying dividend? Why is their share price higher than them? And the those ones are not the one that value. Is it not the same market? Are they operating from heaven? Are they operating from South Africa? They are domiciled here and in business here. And they are doing very well.
You cannot talk beyond your level of understanding. And I sympathize with his disappointment.
Welcome back. We now move on to the highlights of the fourth valedictory lecture of the Chartered Institute of Bankers of Nigeria, CIBN, which was held recently at the Harbour Point, Victoria Island. Topic was the emergence of a Nigerian Pan-African Bank. Speaker was the former GMD of UBA, Mr. Phillips Oduoza. The CIBN Valedictory Lecture Series is a platform for honoring bankers who have had outstanding careers in the banking and finance industry.
The Chartered Institutes of Bankers of Nigeria, CIBN, is the training institution for bankers in Nigeria. The CIBN recently put together its fourth valedictory lecture at the Harbour Point Event Hall, Victoria Island, Lagos. The topic was the emergence of a Nigerian Pan-African Bank. Speaker was the outgoing Group Managing Director and Chief Executive of United Bank for Africa PLC, Mr. Philip Oduoza. Chairman of Vocation was Dr. Pascal Dozie, OON, Founding Chairman, MTN Nigeria, and Founder, Diamond Bank PLC. Welcoming guests to the lecture, Mr. Jude Moye, Executive Director, Heritage Bank, who stood in for Mr. Ifie Sekibu, MD, Heritage Bank, and Chairman, Research, Strategy and Advocacy Committee, CIBN, said that the CIBN Valedictory Lecture Series is a platform for honoring outstanding bankers who have had outstanding careers in the banking and finance industry.
The Institute's Valedictory Lecture Series is a platform to honor retiring bankers and academics who have had outstanding meritorious service in the banking and finance industry, in particular in the nation in general. The lecture is also to provide an opportunity for banking and finance professionals who are proving their mettle to share their thoughts and experiences with their fellow colleagues and in general public.
Also lending his voice to welcome guests to the lecture, the President and Chairman of Council of the Institute, Professor Shegu Ajibola, noted that young bankers can learn from Mr. Oduoza's professional career. Mr. Philip Oduoza cut his teeth in banking as a credit analyst at the defunct International Merchant Bank, IMB, where his sharp intellect was quickly recognized and put into the very important task of managing the loan portfolio of the then high-profile agency, National Directorate of Employment, NDE, which he did successfully. Delivering the topic of the lecture, the emergence of a Nigerian Pan-African Bank, Mr. Oduoza said that UBA moved into other parts of Africa because they believed that the emergence of a Pan-African Bank will help to drive financial inclusion on the continent.
We moved into Africa because we saw increasing opportunities due to the improving political climate, steady growth in GDP, growing workforce, and rapidly increasing disposable income. We also realized that the presence of Pan-African financial institutions will help drive financial inclusion across the continent and foster integration through inter-African trade. We are also going to see how inter-African trade is playing so much role in the economic development of the continent.
Mr. Oduoza's lecture was greeted with a standing ovation. Leading the pack of goodwill messages were Dr. Uju Ugubunka, former Registrar and Chief Executive of CIBN, and Professor Ejike of the University of Lagos. In their usual characteristics, presentations were made to Mr. Odoza.
Congratulations to you and wish you the very best of luck for your future.
Mr. Odoza, who took over from Mr. Tony Elumelu as GMD in August 2010, has taken UBA to great heights. Under his watch, UBA has been successfully established as a Pan-African financial brand with active participation in infrastructure, finance, and large ticket transactions in key emerging sectors across Africa, including power, oil and gas, telecoms, and agriculture, through provision of credits and financial advisory services.
All right, that's all we have time for on this edition of the program. Here is hoping you enjoyed every bit of it. Join us again next week for a fresh package. For now, do feel free to contact us for inquiries and even suggestions on 01-7763981 or 080-335-7879 or 090-9685-2685 or send us an email on almond4xx@yahoo.com or almondproduction@gmail.com. Do visit our website almondreports.com. Like us on our Facebook page, Almond Finance and Wealth Reports, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Almond Reports TV, to view past episodes of this program. As always, I urge you to join us every Wednesday by 9:45 a.m. live on Niger FM 102.7 for our Pidgin English program, Waiting Insurance They Do Self. We are also available on WhatsApp on 080-335-7879, and you can follow us on Twitter at Madam Insurance. This program also airs on BCOS Television every Thursday by 6 p.m. for those in Ibadan and environs. My name is Jennifer Obidiebube. Until next time, remember to be your brother's keeper and stay safe, especially in this period of Ember Month. From all of us here, it's goodbye.